Thanks for checking out this video. So this is one of my opinion videos if you haven't seen them yet. And that's just basically where I'm a little bit more relaxed. I don't have notes on my phone that I'm actually going off of. And just kind of talk about something that I either find interesting, something I want to present my opinion on, or something that's driving me crazy, which this is one of those ones that it's something that's driving me nuts. So this might be a little rant-ish, but there's merit to this, I will say that. So I've seen too many films recently that fit into the realm of being too long. Films that you can tell were padded or seem to be padded for a specific runtime. Now, if you think about it, a lot of films when they come out, especially horror films, are usually hitting somewhere between an hour and a half and 2 hours, usually closer to the hour and a half mark, because that's kind of like the industry rule of, you know, an hour and a half is probably more than enough time for a horror film. Now, that said, there are plenty of other films who kind of go off, do their own thing, usually more independent, who will say, you know, hey, you know, it only takes us an hour and 15 minutes. Or in the example of, and I know I do this all the time in my reviews, the film Host on Shudder. Not like the biggest fan of the actual film. I think it was executed well for what it is. It's just not my subgenre that I really enjoy. But one of the things I love that they did, and I greatly appreciate, and more people need to do, is they had a runtime that was just for how much story they needed to tell. They didn't even feel like they needed to hit an hour. It was, I think it's like 56 minutes or something like that. And that's wonderful because it feels compact. It feels like it's a tightly written script, even though I know some of the stuff was kind of improv'd. But those are the types of films that I want to see. Those are the types of films I think the majority of people want to see. I don't know anyone. I'm just saying I don't know anyone. I'm sure there's someone out there. And if you're this person, put it in the comments and let me know. But I don't know anyone who goes to see a film either at the theater or at home and says, man, I want to make sure I spend at least an hour and a half at the theater or sitting here watching this film. Or I want to make sure that I'm using at least an hour and a half to 2 hours of my life. No, it's usually the opposite of that, and I'm the opposite way. I'll look and I'll be like, you know, I have other things to do. I only have X amount of time. Let's go, you know, is this movie too long? I can't watch it right now. I'd like it on the shorter end. So really, the industry needs to kind of adapt to the times. You know, we're certainly in a time where people are more busy than ever with hobbies, with their work, with all sorts of things in life, just keeping up with, you know, if you're a homeowner, just keeping up with that stuff, you know. There's a lot that you have to deal with. If you have children, you know, all sorts of stuff. You're going to school, whatever. Don't waste our time, because time is very much precious. And the other thing is, you're also wasting time in production. You're wasting money to make a film a certain length. And I know that the length is based off of an industry standard for a reason, but I think that's probably changed at this point. And I really think that it needs to be reevaluated, because it drives me nuts when I'm seeing these films, and I've seen a lot of them recently, where I get done with it and I'm like, it's too slow. It is way too slow. And it's not slow because it needed to be slow. It's slow because it feels like a lot of the shots went on way too long and they should have been edited down, or they were intentionally putting extra stuff in there that's totally not needed, that 100% seems like it's in there to pad the time to get it to that 1.5 hours. So do this. Go through your collection, you know, go through your collection of films, and, you know, maybe I should actually take my own advice on this, and pull them out and just start looking at how long these movies are. And they're usually pretty close in timing. I'm just saying, like, the fact that that is the case is not good. It's saying that they're trying to all fit into the same category of runtime, and that's not what's needed. What is needed is, what story do you have to tell? Can you do it in a succinct manner that makes the movie move well, and you get everything you need from it? You have the rich characters, you have the character development, you have a full range of the story that you need, you get the resolution that you want. If you have all the components, and it's not an hour and a half, say it's an hour and 10 minutes, say it's under an hour, do it. That's what we should be doing. And those things should go into theaters too. It shouldn't be just the hour and a half to 2 hour films making it in theaters or making it onto streaming services. You know, one of the great things about Netflix has been that they have shows that usually would have been on television otherwise. They have shows that not every running time is exactly an hour or what is ends up being like 40 some minutes because of commercial time. It's not geared towards that. It's however much it takes. But then you do also have those instances where you can tell that they ordered a certain number of episodes and there's not enough material for those episodes. So there just being ends up being an insane amount of padding for those episodes. Iron Fist. Well, that's just a mess in general, but you know, anyway, I think I'm coming kind of to the end of my rant. And the big thing is this, I want to kind of put this out there because I think a lot of people feel this, like what I'm feeling with this, but they don't talk about it. Like I don't see people talking about, we need to be cutting down runtime where it's unnecessary. Now, if a film has a long runtime and you watch it and you're like, wow, that was 2 hours. It did not feel like 2 hours. Great. That is totally fine. Because that means they needed that time to tell that story. And that's great. I am down for that. But this situation of being like, oh man, we're at like an hour and 15 minutes on this film. We got to add 15 minutes more. No, that thinking should be gone. That needs to go. So anyway, I just want to hear from other people. Put in the comments, do you feel me on this one? Or are you that person who sits down and is like, man, I would really like to kill an hour and a half to 2 hours right now. I want to find the longer films. Because I'm pretty sure that everyone I've ever talked to, it's more they look and they're like, this film's too long for right now. I need to go get a shorter one. But anyway. Oh, and that also leads me to something to tack on to the end, which I should make just an entire video for this. But short films are film. And they're very enjoyable film, and I don't think they get enough credit, and I think they should get more credit, so I should probably do a separate video about that, but just want to tack that on to the end, because it, you know, fits into the whole runtime thing. But, sorry this was a little bit rambling at times, but put your comments down there, let me know your thoughts about film runtime. Does this bother you at all? Because it's really been driving me crazy lately, like, I was raging about it last night to my wife, and she was just like, Yeah, I feel you. I think she was patronizing me a little bit, but you know, that's what you do when you're a spouse. But yeah, put your comments down there. Thank you. Hit the subscribe button if you can, and you can. It literally takes a second, and that's your way to keep me motivated to not only do these videos, but mainly do my movie review videos, so I would appreciate that. Also, hit the notification bell button, because then that way you'll know when I'm putting up any new videos. But regardless, I really do thank you checking this out, and you know, at least appearing to care what my opinion is on this stuff. And if you watch it and you don't, that's fine too. I'm just kind of throwing it out there. I just want to get as many people on this bandwagon of let's change this runtime culture in the film industry. This has to go. But anyway, thanks for taking your time to watch this. Until next time, keep it brutal.